What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. Today's video is sponsored by Warface. Warface is a dynamic first-person shooter available for free on the PS4, Xbox One, PC, and now on the Nintendo Switch as well. New players on the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One get a free Gorilla Skin Bundle, and if you're a new player on the Nintendo Switch, you'll get the Gorilla Skin Bundle, a tactical axe, and a VIP booster for 7 days, all for free. If this is something that interests you, please consider using my link down below to play Warface for free. Thank you all so much for supporting my channel. Let's go ahead and talk a little bit about Warface, because this isn't the first time that I've actually played this game on the channel. I've played this game before multiple times. I've uploaded multiple videos about it when they weren't sponsored like this one, and it is a game that I actually enjoy. Not only do you get a AAA experience because of everything that's cram-packed in here, we're talking a full-fledged PvE, a full-fledged PvP that features game modes like TDM, free-for-all, bag and tag, which would be something like kill confirmed. Then there's plant the bomb, which would be similar to search and destroy. There's lots of really cool modes to play and experience. But on top of that, there's also a co-op experience, and then there's also a spec ops experience, and spec ops is just wild. There's a bunch of different missions that you're able to choose from. Out of all of the spec ops missions, the one that stuck out to me absolutely has to be Pripyat. I love the fact that we're going through the Chernobyl exclusion zone, we're exploring the apartment complexes, we get to go into the gigantic pool, and we're learning more about the backstory and how the SEDs came to be, or the SEDs. These robots are being built by Blackwood's facility, and they've discovered a brand new element, and it's up to your team to go in and infiltrate, try to find out as much as you can, and well, it all leads up to a bigger story, which can be concluded by playing through the Spec Ops mode. Each one of them have their own little backstory and comics that you're able to look at, and of course, you experience that through dialogue in the gameplay as well. It adds more to the lore of the SEDs and how they came to be, and of course, the fact that you're able to use the SEDs in multiplayer. Now that's just pretty cool. So the SED is a robot character, or a cyborg if you will, and it's actually going to give you unlimited ammunition while playing the PvP. I have some gameplay that I'll put up on the screen right now so you guys can check it out, but this has you using the chainsaw light machine gun, and the only way to fire this is from the hip. You can't actually aim down sight with it. There's unlimited ammunition. The only thing you have to watch out for is the overheat meter. If this weapon overheats, then it's going to take a few seconds for it to cool down before you're able to start using it again. It does pack a powerful punch, but it's definitely meant more for defense than anything else. I think that overall, though, it can be very good for laying waste to any person coming your way. In this game of free-for-all, it was particularly useful coming against a bunch of enemies running into my view, and of course, just being able to take down a certain area and hold a location. That's really what's important with this particular weapon. Since we're on the topic of defense, I just want to say that this is most likely a class that you're going to want to use in modes like Storm, Blitz, or Capture. Something where you're able to protect an objective or protect a carrier. That way you're able to make sure your team is victorious. And I think that overall, it's interesting to see how it started, but I'd really like to see where the said class goes moving forward. Now, based on the gameplay that you're watching, you can clearly see that even at longer distances, this chainsaw can be particularly effective. But one thing you need to keep in mind is you're only firing from the hip. So if there are multiple enemies running at you or multiple enemies within your FOV, you can attempt to take them on at once, but headshots are key to becoming victorious. Oh yeah, one thing I forgot to mention, the said class came out on February 18th with the Titan update. This update was completely free, and the said class is also completely free, so you can hop in game right now and use it if you'd like. There's a total of 5 different classes now. We have Rifleman, Medic, Engineer, Sniper, and said. Of course, we just got done talking about said, but all of the other classes have their own unique weaponry that you're able to use, as well as their own unique special item. For example, the Rifleman is able to drop down ammunition not only for himself, but also for the teammates around him. The Medic is able to revive dead teammates and provide health care for those that took too much damage in the fight. The Engineer class is able to repair broken armor plates, and he just got a new ability. You're able to revive fallen SEDs. So similar to the defibrillator for regular teammates, if a cyborg goes down, your engineer is able to revive those, which I think is pretty dang cool. And as for the sniper, well, the sniper is just a sniper. There's no special here. other than your trusty bolt action sniper and you're getting one-shot kills all day long no matter where you hit the enemy on the body, it's a lot of fun. I love using the sniper category in this game, and we've talked a lot about that before here on the channel. PvP is interesting for a few different reasons, because the weapons themselves are so drastically different. There are over 300 different weapons in this game, and the cool part is, they're not made up or funny weapons. They're all something that's pulled from the real world. One of my favorite weapons that I've unlocked in this game is the MPX SIG. This thing is beautiful, and it cuts through people like a hot knife through butter. In this gameplay of Team Deathmatch, I dropped 63 kills with it, and it's absolutely devastating with how powerful it is. I like the fact that you can also flip the attachments on the fly. This is something that we've discussed here on the channel before. Not only can you just change out your reticle, you can also change up your grips, you could change out your barrels, you could do all of this while you're standing there in game. So find a safe spot, by the way, if you wanted to do this, because you could still get taken out while you're trying to change up your attachments. But it's pretty nice, because if you notice there's a sniper on the enemy team or you need a higher magnification reticle, you could change that out as you see fit. And it doesn't require you to die and respawn for the changes to take place. It just happens right then and there. I love that so much. So obviously, when it comes to a game like this, a lot of people are going to make the connections and say, oh, you know, this is kind of like Call of Duty. This is kind of like Battlefield. And yeah, a lot of first-person shooters are similar in that sense. And I would actually feel like the movement is almost more Destiny-like in this game, as to where the class system is almost like Battlefield. It doesn't really give me Call of Duty vibes unless we're talking about the settings menu. For example, I'm used to playing on a tactical button setting layout, and I can actually do that in this game. It's called tactical, it's super familiar, and it makes it really easy to just get used to the controls. I guess that's one other thing that I should mention. If you've never played anything other than Call of Duty or Battlefield, the controls aren't going to feel foreign to you. They're going to feel exactly as you would expect. It's not going to be much learning. It's just going to be a lot of playing and then getting better, obviously. Out of every single one of the five classes that are available in this game, I think that my favorite is the sniper class. We've talked about this in a separate video dedicated to the sniper class, but it is so satisfying to get that one-shot kill with the Barrett M98. This thing just packs a powerful punch, and as long as you're able to snipe them, not only can you get them while they're running out of their spawn, but as soon as they spawn if you hit them in the head. So you have to really be diligent on that. And I think that it's really fun to just kind of perch up and snipe as a sniper should. In so many games, you see people running around and quickscoping and doing these crazy things, and obviously, you can still do stuff like that in this game, but it's really satisfying to just take out an unsuspecting player with your sniper from across the map, and I love doing that. It's a lot of fun. By the way, that's one thing that I didn't even mention. There are so many challenges and things to do in this game. Take a look at this list of calling cards. It takes forever to scroll through all of them. Calling cards for different weapons being used, calling cards for doing different things in different game modes, for playing different game modes, emblems for playing different game modes, backgrounds for playing different game modes, commendations for playing different game modes and different modes and completing different things and using different weapons, and oh my god! There's a lot to do in this game. So, Spec Ops and Co-op are a little bit different, as to where Co-op is almost like a campaign mission, if you will. Spec Ops takes place in one large arena. The co-op mode gameplay that you're looking at right now takes place from a mission called Shooting Chopper, where it's up to you and your team to restore friendly air traffic in the region. So it's up to you and your team to clear out all enemy infiltrators and then make your way back to the evac chopper. The evac chopper will then take you to the rooftop, where it's up to you to fight off this enemy hind. And to me, I just get mega flashbacks of Metal Gear Solid 1. I know that that sounds crazy, but hear me out for a second. In Metal Gear Solid 1, you're on the rooftop fighting off Liquid Snake, and you have to use Stinger missiles to take out the Hind, and that's kind of the vibe that I get from this. So it's totally a warm welcome to me when I have to do that right now here on this rooftop. And the mission itself, after completing it, you get on the evac chopper, and that is the end. The point is, you're supposed to try to complete these as quickly as you can. You're also supposed to try to complete them without taking any downs, and you get crowns from this. Crowns can be used for different items in-game, and it can also be used to unlock items permanently to use in your inventory, which you can actually customize your weapons even more than you're seeing in my footage here. It just comes down to playing the game game, unlocking certain things, or going to the shop and getting really cool items like golden ACRs, golden weapons in general, and the weapons of the week that you can actually pick up, purchase, and have permanently within your inventory to use. With that said, I thank you all so much for coming out to my video here today. Big thank you once again to the team at Warface for sponsoring today's video. Please use my link down below in the description to play Warface for free. Once again, it's available on PS4, Xbox One, PC, and now on the Nintendo Switch as well. If you guys enjoyed my video here today, do me a favor, drop a like on it, subscribe for more videos coming very soon, and if you haven't yet, don't forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Peace!